If you're in your 30s and 40s and you've started noticing changes around your cycle, whether it's your period itself or PMS, or if you just feel like something's off and you're wondering if it's your hormones, this video is for you. Because today we're diving into some of the common symptoms of hormonal changes that can happen in your 30s and 40s. So we'll talk about what these symptoms might mean, what might be causing them, and we'll talk about what you can do to start to rebalance your hormones naturally. Hi, I'm Kelsey Ale. I am a certified functional nutritional therapist. I'm a restorative wellness practitioner, and I'm the founder of Audre. We are a collective that helps women in their 30s and 40s learn how to age well and love doing it. We talk about hormones and supplements, nutrition, skincare, exercise, and more. So if that sounds interesting or relevant to you, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to our channel and remember to hit the bell to be notified when we post a new video. So if you're noticing signs and symptoms of hormonal shifts in your 30s and 40s, first of all, I really want to reassure you that you're not alone. So many women start to notice changes in their bodies around this time. And second of all, and most importantly, you're not crazy. It can be so easy for some doctors or even for us to brush off our own concerns because you're not in menopause yet or because you're too young. But the reality is there is a lot going on in our physiology during these years. And just because we aren't in menopause yet, that doesn't mean that things aren't happening in our bodies and with our hormones that are affecting our quality of life on a daily basis. The reality is that our hormones can start to change as early as in our mid-30s. And we're gonna break this down. This might be a little uncomfortable, but let's acknowledge that a lot of us in this age range might feel a little disconnected from the word menopause because it feels like kind of a distant concept that isn't relevant to us yet. But the reality is that what we think of as menopause is actually the end result of a years and sometimes decade plus long transitional journey that's marked by subtle and sometimes not so subtle changes and symptoms along the way. So menopause starts for most women in their early to mid 50s, and a lot of women may start to experience signs of perimenopause in their early to mid 40s. But like I said, sometimes it can even start as early as in your mid-30s. So our hormones can actually start changing much earlier than we may realize. And before we dive in, if you are noticing signs and symptoms of hormone shifts right now, it does not necessarily mean that you are about to go into menopause tomorrow or that you're even officially in perimenopause. It may be early perimenopause symptoms, but it well may be that your hormones are being affected by other lifestyle factors, and we'll talk about those later on in this video. I really encourage you to pay attention to these lifestyle factors first and do what you can in those areas before you jump to conclusions or think you need hormone replacement therapy or just generally assume that the end is near. and again, I really do want to reassure you that there are lots of ways to manage your symptoms naturally. All of the hormonal symptoms we'll talk about today are going to be caused by fluctuating levels of estrogens, progesterone, and testosterone, and the fluctuating ratios and relationships between those hormones. But our hormones aren't isolated in our body. They're not in a bubble. So there are other systems that are being affected and that are affecting our hormones. And again, we'll talk more about this. These are some of the lifestyle factors I mentioned, so we'll discuss those towards the end of the video. So first, let's go ahead and dive into the common symptoms of hormonal changes in your 30s and 40s. Now, one of the first symptoms of hormonal shifts you'll probably start to notice in your 30s and 40s is your period changing. Now, these changes might be subtle, but you know your body and you can just kind of tell something's off. So the first way your period may change is in its timing. If you have been a person who has a religiously accurate 28 or 30 day menstrual cycle that you used to be able to set your watch by before we all had smartphones, you may start to have periods that are 1 to 2 days late or 1 to 2 days early or even a few more days early or late in either direction. More than likely, you'll start to notice your cycle getting a little bit shorter over time because this is the most common tendency as we get older. But as crazy as it sounds, your cycle may start to vary and it can be anywhere from 21 to 35 days long. Again, even if you were cycling exactly every 28 or 29 days on the dot for the last 10 years. And just a side note here, if you're having periods that are more than 35 days apart or less than 21 days apart, or if your periods are lasting longer than 7 days, you might want to consider talking to a hormone specialist who can help you get some testing done to uncover the potential causes of these bigger imbalances. So just something to consider. Now, if your periods have always been a little bit irregular, timing changes might not be what you're noticing, but the heaviness of bleeding might be changing for you. Specifically, you might notice that your periods are starting to get quite a bit heavier. You might notice different colors or bigger clots during menstruation. And you could also notice your period getting lighter. It really just depends on what your hormones are doing in your body. But typically, most people notice some change in the amount they're bleeding during their period. These changes in our periods are related to shifting levels of estrogen and progesterone, as well as what we like to call upstream hormones, like follicle stimulating hormone. And all of these together control how we ovulate and when we shed the uterine lining. Now, some of these symptoms of irregular periods and changes can be caused by stress levels and chronic stress, as well as the health of our adrenal glands. And this is in addition to the normal hormone fluctuations we experience as we age. Another common sign of hormonal imbalance in your 30s and 40s is insomnia, my least favorite. You may find yourself either having a hard time falling asleep, or you can fall asleep fine, but then you wake up in the middle of the night and you're really alert and you can't fall back asleep, at least not for a couple hours. And just, you probably just generally don't feel as rested as you used to. And this is again, thanks to shifting hormones, either low progesterone or low estrogen can cause insomnia symptoms, because with low estrogen, your body can't make adequate amounts of melatonin, which is the hormone that helps you fall asleep. And with low progesterone, we start to see a disruption in our GABA uptake, which is a neurotransmitter that normally would calm your mind down and make sleeping through the night a lot easier. Next, we have moodiness. Anxiety, irritability, and depression become more common with hormonal imbalances in our 30s and 40s. Depression can be caused by higher levels of progesterone in relationship to estrogen. And this mild depression happens because elevated levels of progesterone can kind of turn down our estrogen receptors. And estrogen, it turns out, is needed for serotonin production, which is the feel-good hormone. Low progesterone and relatively higher estrogen levels, on the other hand, can actually make you feel a little bit more anxious or irritable. We also have low testosterone as a potential factor. Testosterone is a hormone. We don't really think about that often when it comes to women, but it is also a cause of irritability when it's low. And yes, testosterone is important for everyone. We just have it in varying amounts, but for us, it's crucial for our stamina, for our libido, and for our mood. Next, fatigue and trouble concentrating are also common symptoms. Inability to concentrate, especially if you are moody also, can be a sign of elevated estrogen. Remember, that's elevated in relationship to all of your other hormones. It doesn't necessarily mean that you have sky-high levels of estrogen. You just have more than is beneficial for your hormonal ratio. So that's high estrogen, whereas low estrogen can actually leave you feeling fatigued. And low testosterone can also be another cause of fatigue that you might be experiencing with hormonal imbalances in your 30s and 40s. And now we come to low libido. Let's be real. It's hard to feel sexy when you're exhausted all the time. And also your hormones that are responsible for desire, which are estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone, are also possibly declining or just out of whack. Plus, with all these hormonal fluctuations and potential declines, it does make it harder to climax, which is a bummer. So it's like you want to be intimate, you're still attracted to your partner, you still love them, you have a crush on them, you just seriously don't have the energy or the big desire or the turn on. So low libido can be another really common symptom that we start to experience in our 30s and 40s that is related to hormone changes. Last, we're going to talk about something more superficial, biology jokes, and that is your skin type changing. So first of all, the texture and fullness of your face might be different now. Decreased progesterone means decreased collagen levels. So our faces start to deflate a little bit and lose their firmness. Now this process can actually start as early as your late 20s, but by the time we're into our 30s and especially into our 40s, the effects are becoming more visible and more noticeable. Your skin thickness may also begin to thin, and you might have more noticeable fine lines and more dryness. And these are all related to declining estrogen levels. But if you're noticing your skin going in the opposite direction, it may actually mean your testosterone levels have become elevated, which can result in oilier and sometimes more acne-prone skin. All right, now there are tons of other symptoms we could dive into today, like breast tenderness, weight gain around your midsection, and vaginal dryness. But I think what we just talked about are seven of probably the most common and also sometimes the most subtle changes that can creep up on us as our hormones start to shift in our 30s and 40s. And I'm really curious if this feels real or familiar or like something you're experiencing. Let us know in the comments, because if you're experiencing any or all of the symptoms above, you're not alone. So what does this all mean? What do all these symptoms mean? And more importantly, what can you do about it? Well, first, again, just remember you're not alone. What you're going through is so incredibly common. Every woman goes through these hormonal shifts, and most women will begin to experience bigger hormonal shifts and perimenopause symptoms between the ages of 40 and 44. But every body is different. So if you're younger than that and experiencing these symptoms, it's okay. And I'm right there with you. So what it means is it's time to reassess your self-care strategy. You'll really need to start making some meaningful lifestyle changes if you want to rebalance your hormones naturally. And it's going to require a little bit more focus and a little bit more intentionality than you may have needed in the past. One important point to note is that our hormones become more closely tied and reliant upon our adrenal glands as we move towards our 50s. So starting to do what you can to support your adrenal glands now with lots of rest and an emphasis on good quality sleep is going to be crucial. Good sleep practices look like no electronics or TV or screens for 1 to 2 hours before you go to bed. Trying to go to bed at a similar time and waking up at a similar time every day. Also aiming for 7 to 9 hours of sleep each night. And make sure your room is dark and that it's at an appropriate temperature, which is cool. Also practicing daily meditation and mindfulness can help manage stress levels. And this is great for supporting our adrenal health. Our adrenals also love balanced blood sugar, so eliminating refined starches and sugars from our diet and focusing on proteins and healthy fats with some complex carbs and tons of veggies is going to help a lot. Next, we need to start exercising regularly. Weightlifting in particular is going to help boost your testosterone and help regulate your estrogen levels as you build lean muscle. So if you've been feeling lethargic or unsexy, lifting heavy things a few times a week will give your libido and your energy a boost. And I'm also going to recommend that you slow down on the chronic cardio because at this point it may only be stressing your adrenals more, which may be the case if you're experiencing hormonal imbalances, and this will just lead to potentially more imbalance down the road. So opt for shorter, higher intensity bursts of cardio over long, drawn-out sessions. Now, we touched on balanced blood sugar, but it needs to be said again. Balancing your blood sugar is going to help stabilize your energy levels, it's going to improve your sleep, and it's going to support healthy hormonal balance, especially with estrogen and testosterone. First of all, dysregulated blood sugar has a huge relationship to most of the symptoms we talked about today. It can cause insomnia and moodiness and fatigue and trouble concentrating, and it is related to hormone production. So if you have any type of hormonal imbalance that's been diagnosed or undiagnosed, so whether it's just symptoms of heavy or prolonged periods, if you've been diagnosed with PCOS, or you just have bad PMS symptoms, balancing your blood sugar should be one of the first places you start. Blood sugar dysregulation is also really common and not necessarily for the reasons you may think. So it's most common to think about cutting out sugar and refined starches, like we said, when we think about eating to balance our blood sugar, which is true and it's also really important. But you could already be eating really clean or eating a healthy diet. And if you're not eating enough total food or you're not eating enough protein and fat in relationship to all the fruits and vegetables you're eating, then your blood sugar is still going to be all over the place and it will exacerbate the symptoms you're experiencing. So eat enough protein, eat an adequate amount of healthy fat, and of course, reduce starchy carbs and refined sugars to balance your blood sugar naturally. So to recap, when it comes to balancing your hormones naturally, you really need to start by reassessing your self-care and lifestyle habits. These are also the areas you have the most control over. So get adequate sleep, reduce stress, move your body and exercise. Remember, lift heavy things, short bursts of cardio, and balance your blood sugar. Now, this all may seem like common sense, but are you actually doing these things? Because there are some things that I talked about today as far as solutions that you may have already known are important, but that isn't the same as practicing these habits every day, which is what's actually going to help make the changes that you want to make in your body and in your hormones. And I don't know if it's motivating for you or not. It is for me, but it might be motivating for you to know that 80% of how we age is tied to our lifestyle habits, specifically, not genetics, lifestyle habits. So doing what you can now to build better habits is really what's going to determine what life is like for you in 20, 30, 40 years, and it will determine what your transition through perimenopause and into menopause is like, 100% hands down. So if you want to find out if your current lifestyle habits are making you age faster, you can check out our Real Age quiz linked down below. You can also check out the description below this video for links to more resources like our daily habits calendar that you can join to support you in building the habits you need to age well. If you liked this video and found it useful, go ahead and hit the like and subscribe and share it with your friends. This makes a really big difference and helps out our channel a lot. And make sure that you subscribe to our channel so you can be notified when we post new videos. All right, I'll see you next time.